Hey Silje, and welcome back to a new reading diary. I want to share with you what books I'm planning on reading this week. But first, last night I finished Flights by Olga Tokarczuk, and I adored it. It is such an amazing read, and I did talk quite a bit about it in my previous video, so I won't get into it now, but I can't wait to just read it again or flip through it again and reread some of my favorite passages and fragments, because this is a book that is, yeah, it's amazing. Read it. My main book this week will be another Vesaas. This is Båten om kvelden. It has been translated to The Boat in the Evening and also The Hill's Reply. And The Hill's Reply is an Archipelago edition, which is translated by Elisabeth Drokkan, who also translated The Ice Palace. So that translation must be superb. And I have been craving more Vesaas since I reread both The Seed and The Ice Palace in April and May. And I am so happy that Paperbird also wanted to read more Vesaas right now, because now we're reading this together. And yeah. This is said to be Vesaas' most experimental novel, and it is his last novel, written a couple of years before he passes away. And as you can see, I have read a bit already. And he is experimenting with different genres, so you can find some poetry here, you can find kind of like prose poetry in a way, and chapters that are more like short stories, and yeah. So far I am a couple of chapters in, it is really really awesome. It's also said to be his most autobiographical work, so yeah, I can't wait to get to know Vesaas in his own words, in a way. The other book that I will be reading this week is Northern Lights, The Kingdom of the Trolls by Malin Falch, and this is the fourth installment of The Northern Light, which is a Norwegian portal fantasy graphic novel series for kids, which is just amazing because we don't have a lot of those here. And this is about Sonja, and she is from our world, and she is transported to this magical place where there are trolls and magical creatures and Vikings, and there is this conflict between the Vikings, who are human, and the magical creatures, and Sonja is a big part of that. And I really love how Malin Falch is using Norwegian fairy tales and folklore in her stories, and she makes her own spin on it. And yeah, I'm just super excited to read this one, and yeah, it's great, and I really like some really good children's books. And this one is really short, so I'm sure that I will be finishing this up pretty fast, and I will also need to find another book, but I'm not sure what book to pick yet, so I will keep you updated. So yeah, talk soon. One thing that I really like with this book, or this series,
is that Malin Falch is inspired by a lot of different Norwegian fairy tales, and she also draws this trolls, and I can see how they are inspired in many ways by the famous troll painter or fairy tale painter here in Norway called Theodor Kittelsen. He was the one that illustrated or collected fairy tales back in the 1800s. And I really like how she is honoring that style, but at the same time is making her own spin on it and brings her own personal style to it. It's just so incredibly adorable. These are the friends of Espen and Sonja, and they are like little trolls, and they are super adorable.
I am so happy that summer is here, but at the same time, the sunblock is making my face so shiny. I'm sorry. But I just finished Northern Lights, The Kingdom of the Trolls by Malin Falch. And as I said previously, this is the fourth book in the series, and this was a great continuation. And we get to meet new creatures from the Norwegian folktales, which makes me really happy. And we get to learn more about this world, about the trolls and the Vikings and the conflict, and especially the conflict between the humans and the magical creatures. And Sonja is from our world, but in this world we have the Vikings, and they're also not magical, they are humans. And it's interesting to see how the way they are acting towards the magic people, the people that are different, also is a parallel to how different people can be looked upon in real life as well. I think this is a book that I would recommend to people, or especially kids that like the Amulet series, because I think this is kind of in the same style, and it is really exciting and adventurous and such a cool concept. So I'm happy that I read it. As I already have finished one of my books, I need to find another book to read. I have already read my pages of Vesaas today. So good. So good. And I need to have another in-between book. And I'm not sure if I should continue reading some graphic novels or comics, or if I should read something else. I'm kind of craving both graphical novels and also some fantasy, and also some horror, and also some classics and non-fiction. I'm like craving everything, and maybe it's because of the sudden summer here that my brain is a little bit fried. So we'll see what I will come up with.
Reading much.
I have decided on a new secondary book, and no, it's not horror or fantasy or graphic novel. It is this book. It's Mr. Blue by Jacques Poulin. And Jacques Poulin is a French-Canadian author, and this book was translated from the French by Sheila Fishman. This novel is about a man, a writer with writer's block, and he spends his time on an island with his cat, Mr. Blue. And one day, they're walking to the sea, they notice these footprints in the sand, and they decide to follow it into some caves. And in the cave, they find a copy of Arabian Nights. And that is what I know about this book. And I read the first couple of pages, and I really like the way it's written, how it flows, and yeah, I'm curious, and I will keep you updated. I am almost halfway through Båten om kvelden, The Boat in the Evening, The Hill's Reply by Tarjei Vesaas. It's such a mesmerizing book. It is quite different from his other works, but at the same time, it is so Vesaas in the writing. I think you can read this book in many different ways. It says on the back of the book that this is a novel, but at the same time it is challenging the concept of a novel, especially at that time. You can find vignettes here, you can find poetry, and I also think you can read this as a collection of short stories or memories that are intertwined or connected. And it starts with two stories that is told through the eyes of a young boy, a young child. And then it moves to another story, Vår Vinter, or the Spring in Winter, which is about a young girl and a young boy. And the young girl, she's 17, and she is standing there in the snow, and she is waiting for a young boy to meet her. And she is so filled with anticipation, and she let the snow just cover her, and she feels so warm and bubbly inside. And I think that fits perfect with the title of the story. And sadly, the boy doesn't show up, and he sends another boy. And even though she is disappointed, everything turns out in a very nice and tender way. And it is winter, it's cold, and she is filled with this warmth, and she, towards the end, warms this other boy that tries to take the snow off her. And yeah, I thought it was so beautiful and so tender. And yeah, I think Vesaas has this really good way to describe the feelings of being in love for the first time, the anticipation, and yeah, as I've said earlier, he is just so good at describing and understanding people. And then the next story is also about a couple of young boys or adolescents, and kind of this sexual awakening. They are out in the woods in the early morning to capture the sunrise, and they see this young naked girl across the river for them. So it's like he's writing through life in this book, that he starts with the younger years, and then he is working his way
through the end. And I don't know, but that makes me kind of sad. I know this is his last prose book, and yeah, it's so good. It's so, so good. Sigleren sigler med sitt sammensatte følge gjennom landet. Det både hans eget land og det helt ukjente. Det hans strand og hans fugler, hans annerledes i muren, hans rop i ropet. Gåtene hans egne murer han inn, som han selv var en gåte inne på veggene. Hans egen sorg er med. Sorg som ikke anten han selv eller noen annen kan forklare. I just did yoga and it was great, a little bit warm, and I'm about to dive into Mr. Blue by Jacques Poulin, and I'm at page 24 now, and I am not really sure what this book really is about yet, so hopefully after some reading, I'll be a bit more wiser. We'll see. I am reading my main book, Båten om kvelden, The Boat in the Evening, The Hills Reply by Tarjei Vesaas, and I really adore it. But at the same time, how can I explain this? You know, when you are really enjoying a book, you love the experience and the way the words are put together into wonderful sentences, and like the prose, and yeah, just the reading experience. But at the same time, you don't really know what's going on. That is my feeling about this book right now. Some of the chapters are easy to get, or like more straightforward. But there are some chapters that are so abstract and so poetical and very dreamlike and fragmented. So it's hard to really fully grasp what he's trying to tell me. And I kind of like that. And I'm also practicing letting the words just flushed through me, and but yeah, it's an odd but also very fascinating experience, and yeah, as I said, this is a great book and I really like it. Things happen inside us, I mean in the very depths of our beings, but I am certain that if someone had been able to look deep inside me on that foggy August night, he would have seen some peculiar beings, ghosts of the past, nightmare figures, giants and witches, beasts with sleepy eyes. There are powerful ties between souls. In fact, there are such things as kindred spirits, sister souls that seek each other out and aren't content until they've found one another.
This is just to wrap up this reading diary. And last night I finished Mr. Blue by Jacques Poulin, translated from the French by Sheila Fishman. And I ended up really enjoying this book. It's about this middle-aged writer with writer's block who is staying at his childhood home close to a river near Quebec. And he's staying there with his cat, Mr. Blue, and also a lot of stray cats. And one day he is walking along the beach and he sees a set of footprints that leads him to this cave. And in the cave he sees that someone has stayed there, and he finds a copy of Arabian Nights. And this is the start to this story, which introduces us to some really quirky and odd side characters and a lot of cats. And we get an insight into his writing and his dreams and his imagination, and it's told so beautiful and so with warmth. And if I should say something about what this book really is about, I think, in my opinion, it's a really tender and beautiful unraveling of heartbreak and loss. And it's also about finding solace, and yeah, it's a beautiful story. I still haven't figured out why it's called Mr. Blue though, that's the name of the cat, and but he's there in the background, so yeah. This morning I finished the boat in the evening, Båten om kvelden by Tarjei og Vesaas, or The Hills Reply. And I have no idea how to talk about this book. It's a collection of fragments and dreams and images and some short stories and poetry. And I got so mesmerized by everything. And I didn't fully grasp what he was trying to tell me all the time, but that was secondary because just being in this book was such a wonderful reading experience. And I love the way he's like putting these beautiful and powerful images from nature in me, and how he is mirroring nature with the human experience, and like how he's playing with poetry and different genres. And it's really introspective, and it's just like being inside his mind, and being there is so fascinating and beautiful and just amazing. This is a book that I think I will never be finished with. This is a book that I need to revisit again and again, and I know that I will find new things to love about this book every time. It is such a powerful read. I think, however, if you haven't read any Vesaas, this is not the book to start with. I think you should read like The Birds or The Ice Palace, get to know his writing and his writing style, and then when you get to know it, this is the book. It's a beautiful like swan song in a way, and yeah, can't wait to revisit. And yeah, this is the end to this reading diary, and thank you so much for watching. Please let me know in the comments if you have read some of these books and what you thought of them. And yeah, I hope you all are having a wonderful day, and see you soon. Ha det!